Wrestling Federation for over 50 years. The revolutionary force in sports entertainment.
Hello again, everyone, and welcome to the Action Zone. Jim Ross, Todd Pettengill here with you again this week. And here comes the incomparable high-flying 1-2-3 kid.
He really signifies, Jim Ross, the new WWF generation, the high-flying fan favorite 1-2-3 kid in action against Dick Barberi, who's no relation to OJ's girlfriend, Paula.
We don't think.
That's Barberi.
No
relation.
And also, no relation to Howard Finkel, the incomparable ring announcer. Mike Kyoto, the official assigned this contest. The 1-2-3 kid, former WWF Tag Team Champion, along with Bob Sparkplug Holly. They had the old proverbial cup of coffee with the belts.
I'll tell you, folks, we've got a great broadcast for you this afternoon. We'll be speaking with interim president of the World Wrestling Federation, none other than Hall of Famer Gorilla Monsoon.
And Gorilla's already made huge changes in SummerSlam. Of course, SummerSlam coming your way on pay-per-view on August 27th. As Nick Barberi goes behind the 1-2-3 kid, but not for long, as the kid took him over that snapmare. Nice move by the 1-2-3 kid, who is seemingly 100% after suffering the fractured neck about 6 weeks ago. Maybe longer now. Time flies, you're having fun. It's been a huge week here in the WWF. 1-2-3 kid, quicker than that old proverbial hit up and a nice drop kick.
You can't even keep your eye on him, he moves so fast.
1-2-3 kid, certainly one of the most popular young competitors in the World Wrestling Federation. I know that he is very happy that his best friend, Razor Ramon, will be challenging Shawn Michaels at SummerSlam in the ladder match.
Oh, and look at that move, Nick Barberi.
Barberi got a couple of hard right hands in there, and now Barberi challenging the 1-2-3 kid, focusing on that head and neck. Barberi's going to find out for himself if the 1-2-3 kid has completely healed from the neck injury.
Oh.
Hip lock takeover, nicely done.
Well, you're talking about how the bad guy, Razor Ramon, might feel about this match. What about Psycho Sid? How do you think he feels getting tossed out by the interim president?
I understand that Psycho Sid and along with his boss, the Million Dollar Man, Ted DiBiase, are just enraged. And you also got to wonder just exactly how Shawn Michaels thinks about all this situation. The last time he met Razor in the ladder match, Shawn lost. That was at WrestleMania 10 in Madison Square Garden. And Shawn wanted to get his hands on Psycho Sid because, obviously, we all know there's a big score to be settled there.
Well, I'll tell you, Nick Barberi is holding his own this afternoon on the zone against the 1-2-3 kid.
Gets set for the ride, but the kid, the roundhouse heel kick.
So he's going to say something. Turns right around.
1-2-3 kid is very effective when he has the opportunity to use those educated feet. Irish up to the left side of your screen.
You see the elevation on that?
And nowhere for Barberi to go.
He was already buried in the corner, and the kid just made it painful.
He caught him with it right in the side of the head. The 1-2-3 kid with the lateral press, the hook of the leg, technically sound, much to the delight of this capacity crowd. Over 11,000 fans with us this week, Todd.
I got to get a friend that Hitman ice cream.
Oh, really?
Oh, yeah. You want me to get you one?
Absolutely.
I know why I don't like the dentist.
Well, we should point out that all dentists aren't like Isaac Yankum, DDS, thank goodness.
Heaven forbid. Now, folks, let's talk SummerSlam, because Supersize Stridex Pads proudly present SummerSlam, and what a night of World Wrestling Federation action it's going to be. Sunday night, August the 27th, totally live on pay-per-view. We're talking 7 Eastern, 4 Pacific, and we're talking an incredible card of action. Before we get into that, we're being joined now by the new interim president of the World Wrestling Federation, none other than Hall of Famer Gorilla Monsoon.
And Gorilla, thanks for being with us. First question, I understand that Shawn Michaels is rather upset with you, sir, because Shawn's not going to be given the opportunity to extract some revenge from Psycho Sid now at SummerSlam.
Well, you see, Jim Ross and Todd, as interim president here in the World Wrestling Federation, I don't have to play any politics. I don't have to deal with personalities. I'm above that. So really, you know, I could care less what Shawn Michaels thinks because I've got my finger on the pulse of the fans here in the World Wrestling Federation. I know what they want to see, and that's what I'm going to do.
Well, let's talk about your former broadcast partner, the Million Dollar Man, Ted DiBiase. He is livid. I mean, along with Psycho Sid, where do you see this putting Sid in the race for the Intercontinental Championship? Obviously, with the changes that were made, it affects his life dramatically.
Well, I'm sure that Psycho Sid is upset, and I'm sure that DiBiase is as well. He's still trying to find some way to get some gold into his corporation, but this office is not for sale, and I'm still putting the ducks in order here. I haven't finished yet with SummerSlam reviewing the entire card, and, you know, there's other things that are going to happen.
Well, Gorilla, I understand that you're going to make a major announcement, a blockbuster this week on Raw. Do you have the opportunity now to share any of that information with us here this week on the Action Zone?
Well, not really, Jim Ross. I'm still formulating it, and I'm going to have it all worked out, and I can guarantee you the announcement will come on Monday Night Raw tomorrow night.
All right, thank you very much. The interim president of the World Wrestling Federation, none other than Hall of Famer Gorilla Monsoon. I'll tell you, Jim Ross, I'll be quite honest. Gorilla is making some wholesale changes here and only been in office about a week.
He is shaking things up. I can't wait for Raw this week. Apparently, this is going to be a huge announcement from the new president.
Well, let's talk about SummerSlam because an awesome card. You have the World Wrestling Federation Championship on the line between Big Daddy Cool Diesel and the 568-pound King Mabel, who's on an awesome roll.
The thing about this matchup, we pointed this out before, is that Diesel's going to have to change his offensive strategy. Diesel will not be able to use his favorite maneuver, that's the jackknife. There is absolutely no way, folks, that Diesel's going to be able to jackknife the 568-pound King Mabel.
Now let's talk about the legendary Bret the Hitman Hart, who will also be in action at SummerSlam when he faces the man we saw a little while ago, Isaac Yankem DDS Jerry Lawler's former dentist.
Well, I don't know how well Isaac Yankem is going to wrestle, but I can say this, folks. This guy is about 6'9" tall. He looks to be well over 300 pounds. Should be a great physical challenge once again for the Hitman.
Plus, of course, folks, the WWF Intercontinental Championship is on the line as the Heartbreak Kid Shawn Michaels locks up with the bad guy Razor Ramon.
Remember WrestleMania 10. Remember that tremendous matchup in Madison Square Garden? It was Razor Ramon defeating Shawn Michaels. Will the bad guy become the first man in WWF history, Todd, to be the Intercontinental Champion four times?
Well, folks, in a match just announced this weekend, you will also see the man who walks with the angel, the man from the dark side, The Undertaker, locking up with his longtime nemesis, Kama of the Million Dollar Corporation.
Well, Todd, do you like a slobber knocker?
Huh?
Do you like slobber? You like physical wrestling matches?
Absolutely.
In the World Wrestling Federation? I tell you what, folks, this is going to be intense. It's been building a long, long time. Ever since Kama stole the urn from The Undertaker.
And so far, Kama has shown no fear. However, on August the 27th, Kama will look into the eyes of the man from the dark side, and he may not like what he sees.
Oh, yes, Kama. What a supreme fighting machine you really are. But you're a little overconfident in Ted DiBiase's money. The only thing it'll buy for you at SummerSlam is a funeral.
Can you hear it, Kama? The silence is almost deafening. But this is what your future has in store. Dark, cold silence.
Oh, yes. Oh, yes.
Stop it. You're scaring me.
Sorry. August the 27th, Supersize Stridex Pads present SummerSlam. It is going to be awesome, folks. Make room on your calendar, 7 o'clock Eastern, 4 Pacific, from the Igloo, the Pittsburgh Civic Arena, SummerSlam.
And folks, still to come, courtesy of Raw, the WWF Tag Team Championship on the line, the bad guy in Savio took on Yokozuna and Owen Hart. Welcome back, everybody, to The Zone. Jim Ross, Todd Pettengill back with you. And it's time for the defrocked FFA member, that's a future farmer of America.
Thank you.
Henry Godwin. And he's going to meet one of my longtime favorites, Brickhouse Brown.
Ow.
Beg your pardon.
Ow. You know, Brick.
I got it.
House. Ow.
Uh-huh. Oh, you want lunch?
Ooh.
You order anything?
Not that. I told you I was getting an ice cream.
Melee situation by the youngsters here at ringside. And Henry Godwin, who has yet to be officially hired by the million-dollar corporation, and specifically the million-dollar man. And my sources tell me he's getting a little impatient.
Well, he's done everything Ted DiBiase asked him to do.
He's done a lot of dirty work for the million-dollar man. And right now, Brickhouse Brown.
Ow.
Ow, that's right. Right down to the canvas. Spending a little time role-playing as a Rembrandt. Spending some time on the canvas there as Brickhouse Brown.
Well, you're very clever this week.
A lot of sleep last night.
Did you?
Laying off that little decaf for me today.
I'll tell you what, Jim Ross. I think I know what the big announcement's going to be on Raw. You know, from Gorilla Monsoon.
Yeah, what do you speculate?
Harvey Whippleman and Bertha Faye are getting married.
That would be a pretty big announcement. You know, Doc Hendricks told me this week on Challenge, he thinks McMahon's getting fired.
That's ridiculous.
We'll put my money on that one.
He's not getting fired till January. Everybody knows that.
Front face lock by Henry Godwin and Brickhouse Brown up and over. Brickhouse trying to pull a Horowitz here.
Oh, and he almost got it.
And the Godwin, oh, my. That was a...
There you go, Adam Bomb.
Yeah, there you go. Adam Bomb is right.
I'm not Adam Bomb.
I'm not either.
Well, why is he saying that?
Because that's what's on his mind, apparently.
You see that? One-track mind.
He's the one who better... He should think about Adam Bomb, as a matter of fact. Bomb is the guy that's got a big score to settle with the Hog Farmer.
That's right.
They say Bomb washed his hair for like 3 or 4 hours after that slop.
Well, sure, he poured him all over. I mean, it was ridiculous.
Brickhouse slammed again to the canvas, and Henry Godwin puts that big 300-pound elbow on him. You know, Godwin may or may not be called to testify in the Whitewater hearings. I'm not sure. That hasn't been confirmed.
He made a lot of money on that deal.
Oh, really? What do you know about that?
Well, I know he made almost as much as I did with the ABC Disney deal.
Is that why you're wearing those mouse ears?
Hi-ho, hi-ho. It's off to the bank I go.
You're loaded, pal.
Yeah, well.
You going to trade in the Gremlin?
No, would never part with that.
Attaboy.
Keeps me grounded.
What do you mean?
Oh, the seats are just on the ground. Bottom's wearing through.
Those speedboats must be tough.
Oh, they're a killer.
Henry Godwin dropping a killer leg right across the back of Brickhouse Brown, Ted.
Ow.
That's what Brickhouse has been saying for the last 3 or 4 minutes here.
Well, you're not kidding. Henry Godwin not having much trouble with Brickhouse. Ow, on the zone this afternoon.
Brickhouse, except for a little trip there, tries to go up and over. Can he get Brickhouse? Can he get Godwin down? No, he can't.
I wonder what the maitre d' says when his table's ready at a restaurant.
Come and get it.
Table ready for Brick. Mr. Brickhouse. Table.
Paging Mr. B.H. Brown.
There you go.
Godwin has got a... He just is walking through Brickhouse like it was a good Sunday afternoon, and as a matter of fact, it is.
Or a house of straw. But Brickhouse is fighting back now, sends Goblin for the ride into the corner.
And Brickhouse couldn't find the combination to get the big Hog Farmer out of the corner.
I think he ripped his shirt.
Oh, that make him mad.
Oh, boy, he's only got one of those.
I see this guy chewing tobacco, which, that's slot drop, which no one should ever do, and eats his lunch at the same time. This one's over. He just ate Brickhouse Brown's lunch.
Wow. He's mighty, mighty. That's how it's called.
I remember. We're dating ourselves. Is that in the 70s or the 80s?
Oh, there's Granny Godwin and her sister, Thelma. Thelma and Louise Godwin.
Well, we're mighty proud they're with us.
Yeah, right. They drove together. Whatever.
I guess he's coming up.
Who?
Well, Brickhouse is going up, but he's going right back down.
Uh-huh.
The disc is going to be with us.
Oh, you know what? I hope when we throw to him, he doesn't go, thanks, guys.
Probably will.
He'll probably say, hey, guys.
Hey, guys. Hey, guys.
Hey, guys. Check out. I was on my way out to the arena, and I ran into the postman. Had a package for me, and inside the package was a brand new T-shirt. I could not resist showing it to all of our fans first. It's the brand new Property of T-shirt. Property of WWF, the World Wrestling Federation. You can get this T-shirt by dialing 1-800-TITAN-91. As a matter of fact, that's the only way you can get this T-shirt right now. Believe it or not, it's only $14. And if you call, you're going to get Cage Magazine, which is a $4 value, absolutely free. 1-800-TITAN-91, the T-shirt, the magazine. Back to you guys.
Thanks, Bear. Folks, still to come here this week on the Action Zone, we will hear from the World Wrestling Federation champion, Big Daddy Cool Diesel, plus... highlights of that tag team matchup from last week on Raw.
Thanks, Todd.
Back on the zone being brought brought to you this week by new Vigor Stridex medicated pads. It's simple pimple control.
Here comes Bam Bam Bigelow, the beast from the east. Certainly on a vendetta as it relates to the infamous million-dollar corporation.
Well, obviously, Bam Bam has vowed revenge on every member of that corrupt corporation, and he's keeping his promise.
He got fired on April 24th.
No, he quit.
Well, two sides to that story. Fist and fire, Bam Bam Bigelow, and get ready. Boom!
Wow. Holy moly.
I think it took off Finkel's mustache.
That's not real.
It's not?
No, I saw him putting it on.
Darn it.
That's not real.
Where does he keep it?
In the hair closet.
Where's that?
In the rug room. Next to McMahon's piece.
McMahon wears a piece?
Oh, come on. Where have you been? Everybody knows that.
Let's start paying attention. Bill Payne better pay attention to Bam Bam Bigelow. Bigelow, how do you miss him? He's got tattoos all over his skull. Weighs around 400 pounds, and I guarantee you, nobody ever has been any tougher that hails from Asbury Park, New Jersey. And Todd, there's a lot of tough hombres in that neck of the woods.
No question about it, Jim Ross. Folks, still to come on the Zone this week, Doc Hendricks will speak with King Mabel. Apparently, the King has a plan for Diesel this week on Raw.
And we'll hear from Diesel a little bit later in the broadcast. And we have some very special comments you're going to want to stay tuned for from the bad guy, Razor Ramon.
And look at Bill Payne going to work on the beast from the east, Bam Bam Bigelow.
Has Bam Bam overlooked Bill Payne? I don't think so. Great dropkick by the big old Bammer. Boy, he is a very agile man and powerful as well as that hip block, or should I say a hip toss would indicate.
This guy is one of the most agile superstars in the World Wrestling Federation. For his size, his quickness is just unmatched.
We got over 11,000 fans here with us this week in the Zone. And as we have suggested many times, take a look, see the WWF live like this Friday night in New Haven, Connecticut. This Saturday in Madison Square Garden. And a little power here.
Look at this.
Bam Bam Bigelow. And in a week, next Sunday night, Albany, New York. Todd, your own neck of the woods.
The Knickerbocker Arena. What a great facility to watch the World Wrestling Federation.
Bigelow going for the headbutt, but Payne, luckily for him, was able to move out of the way. And the southpaw, Bill Payne, trying to build a little momentum here.
You talk about building momentum on the way to SummerSlam. Tickets are absolutely blowing out the door. The Igloo in Pittsburgh, I suggest you get yours this week if you want to join us live.
I got a lot of relatives in Pittsburgh. My mother-in-law lives there. They're just badgering the heck out of me for tickets.
See? Everybody wants tickets.
Send a check. Buy the ticket.
There you go.
No problem.
Bigelow in total control here this afternoon on the Zone.
Bam Bam Bigelow would love to get his hands on Tatanka in any shape, form, or fashion. And the reason I point out Tatanka is the fact that Tatanka's been doing a lot of mouthing, a lot of bad mouthing. He has been speaking with four tongues, as a matter of fact.
Not Tatanka.
Yeah.
Hard to believe.
Bam Bam's even willing to take on Tatanka in an Indian scrap match.
That's
he
right.
Doesn't care where it is or what it is.
And that's Tatanka's strength.
Yep.
And here goes Bigelow. We said he was agile. You're going to see it firsthand.
Watch this near 400-pound missile. Right off the top. Bam Bam Bigelow wishes it could have been Tatanka or any member of the Million Dollar Corporation.
Jim, tell them about the interview.
Well, Doc Hendricks is going to talk to King Mabel in 30 seconds.
Promotional consideration paid for by the following.
Welcome to Nerf Max Force. It starts with a flurry, 15 darts off in a hurry, muscled by the crank of Razor Beast. Max Force, it's Nerf to the next power.
Batman versus Superman. The Flash versus Wonder Woman. Who is the ultimate superhero? Find out in Justice League Task Force for Super NES and Genesis from Acclaim.
Attention citizens, be on the lookout for Judge Dredd, Mean Machine, and all the Judge Dredd action figures. There's a battle for justice in every action pack. Judge Dredd, pack sold separately.
Okay, Mabel, look, we already know. SummerSlam's 3 weeks away. You signed to wrestle Big Daddy Cool. But man, I know this Monday night on Raw, Moe's gonna wrestle Diesel to knock out a match. What's up with that?
First of all, let's make one thing perfectly clear. The king of the new generation.
Okay, dig it. But listen, you know, what I want to know is, like, since it's a non-title match, is he going to go after Diesel's elbow so he doesn't make him 100% by the time he gets to SummerSlam?
This Monday night on Raw, the saga unfolds. It starts with Sir Mo at Monday Night Raw and ends with King Mabel at SummerSlam. It's all a part of the Royal Plan.
Okay.
Royal Plan.
Like, just between us guys here, you know, I mean, you can let me in. Like, what's he going to do?
Who's Doc Cutting Tongue now?
Wait a minute, Doc. I'm the king. I ask the questions around here. Not only do I ask the questions, but I give the answers. But I want to ask you one simple question. Do you think Big Daddy Cool can jackknife 568 pounds?
Oh, no.
No one thinks that.
Do you think that I can belly to belly 307 pounds?
Oh, yeah, like that, man, like that.
Now you're starting to catch on to the Royal Plan. If you want to know more, tune in this Monday night on Raw.
Long I would suggest...
California, weighing 260 pounds, Goldust.
Goldust will soon be appearing in the World Wrestling Federation, and we can't wait.
Is it a person or a pen?
It is a person, a big person. And Bob Holly, the big smile on his face on his way to the proverbial squared circle to take on Reginald, don't call me J.J. Walker.
Johnny's brother. They call him Red. Boy, Bob Holly, two-sport athlete in the World Wrestling Federation, and he does both extremely well.
How do you think prime time Deion Sanders is going to be playing football this year?
I think he will.
My football reference of the week for my many fans that wait on that.
Oh, I know. Let me write the time down.
Thank you. It is Bob Holly, Reginald Walker, still to come, ladies and gentlemen. We're going to show you some highlights from Raw last week, Contract Takeover. The WWF Tag Team Championship was on the proverbial line, and will be again this week. More on that in the hour.
Boy, they ran out of time, didn't they?
And your dear, close, longtime personal friend, Wayland Mercy, will also be with us.
Well, he's not a friend of mine. You know what I mean?
I do know what you mean.
And I think he's nobody's friend.
He certainly doesn't seem to be very sincere, shall we say.
That's absolutely true. You know, he says one thing, but then he does the complete opposite.
Nice hip lock takeover there by Bob Holly.
And let me digress for a second. What about Mabel and this Royal Plan?
I think it's very simple. I don't think that Mo has any big motivation to beat Diesel this week on Raw. It's a non-title match. He's there to put a chink in the armor of the WWF champion. And where there's Mo, there's King Mabel. Should I say where there's Sir Mo, there's King Mabel. I think it's very obvious that Diesel could be in a lot of jeopardy this week on Raw.
Well, they will not make a court jester out of Big Daddy Cool, I'll tell you that.
No, absolutely not. And where there's Big Daddy Cool, there's Shawn Michaels, the Intercontinental Champion.
There you go.
It could be a very explosive situation this week on Raw, in addition to that restarting of the WWF Tag Title matchup.
Bob Holly better get restarted here, folks. By the way, you can pick up the telephone, call the WWF Superstar Line anytime you like. Here's the number, 1-900-737-4WWF, just $1.49 per minute. It's open 24 hours a day, 7 days a week, and billing doesn't begin until you pick your option. Now, let's talk about option number six, the Ross Report, as Bob Holly continues to have his way with Reggie Walker.
Titled Option 6, we're going to cover a variety of things, several injuries in the WWF, We're going to talk about the retirement of a genuine World Wrestling Federation legend, a surefire Hall of Famer. We're also going to talk about some pending changes that President Gorilla Monsoon is contemplating, having to do with the rules and regulations that the wrestlers compete under. So a lot of things to talk about on option number six.
Talking about changes, Bob Holly changing the molecular structure here of Reggie Walker.
Very analytical.
Thank you.
Very impressed.
Oh, I really did my homework.
And I love that jacket you're wearing.
Thank you very much.
But what happened to the lapels?
They don't make them with that. Is it? Never mind.
It's a nice jacket.
All of your shirts still have those Sammy Davis Jr. collars. You go out in the wind, you'll take flight.
You're right, babe. Well, anyway, Bob Holly is having his way with Reginald Walker. Walker accused Holly of pulling his hair earlier.
He what?
He told the ref Holly was pulling his hair.
What, under his arm?
I don't know. Reginald Walker walking around in a daze, and Bob Holly catches him in the crossbody. Look at the great technique. Rolls Reginald Walker on the shoulders. He hooked the leg, and this capacity crowd likes what they see.
Bob Holly, the two-sport athlete, victorious this afternoon on the Zone. As a matter of fact, guys, if we can go back and show the highlight of this match. Go back and here we go. Now watch Bob Holly. This is absolutely awesome agility here.
And then the perfectly executed crossbody block. Bob Spark Plug Holly with another victory here on the Zone.
Well, folks, a quick programming note for you. Coming up next weekend on WWF Superstars, you're going to see the rematch of sorts. Barry Horowitz once again stepping into the ring with Skip with the Body Donuts.
And Skip says that Horowitz will not or cannot last 10 minutes with him.
Are you kidding?
He says.
So if he does, he wins.
Right.
Let's go back and look at these guys.
And off the rope and now over the top to the outside.
Whoa. Michaels with tremendous ring presence. And Sonny can't believe what's happening to Skip.
I got a question.
Hey, wait a minute. There he is. There is Barry Horowitz. Here he comes. Barry Horowitz coming down the ringside.
Boy, Dexter.
Yeah, look at that. From behind, turn around. Oh, right hand by Michaels. There's a slight fist in Sonny. Right in the presence, right in front of Barry Horowitz. And now Skip fell back into the ring.
Michaels with momentum. Shawn Michaels now with Skip for the ride. And yes, to the buckle. Look out.
Here comes Michaels' wrestler.
Boom.
Michaels now has an opportunity to pin Skip.
Setting up Skip. Open reversal now. Off the rope.
Man, what a battle back and forth for the World Wrestling Federation Tag Team Championship. Now, that match is going to start from scratch. It's going to start all over again this week on Raw. Anything can happen here in the World Wrestling Federation.
Razor, no doubt, will be ready for that one, but he's also had the time to stop by and make some comments regarding the SummerSlam Intercontinental Championship matchup with Shawn Michaels in the ladder match. As a matter of fact, I think you're going to be very interested in listening to these comments. Razor Ramon is very focused, as you will hear.
Yo, chicos, what is this, man? Meet the press? Everybody got questions for Razor Ramon? That Gorilla Monsoon, he's so smart. He knew something that two other people knew. Razor Ramon's number one contender. Razor knows it. Shawn Michaels knows it. How does Razor feel about Shawn Michaels? Hey, he's pretty good. He a three-time intercontinental champ. But chicos, I'm the first three-time intercontinental champ. Michaels, do you respect the bad guy? You better, Chico. Because just think back. The ladder match, the last time we met, I'm the only man to take your precious IC gold. And Chico, talk about Summer Slams. When you're riding down the road with Big Daddy Cool, ask him, Chico. I'm the only one to ever beat him, too.
Man, there is no question, Jim Ross. We are seeing a focused bad guy Razor Ramon. He's taking friendship, putting it on the back burner. There's no question. He wants that Intercontinental Championship belt back.
Well, I'll tell you something. This is how they put their biscuits on the table. This is how they make their living. They'll go all out. Friendship aside, this will be a classic at SummerSlam.
Stay with us, ladies and gentlemen. More Action Zone straight ahead. Hey, we're back. You know what I mean?
Yep. Griffin, Georgia. You know, I think Chief J. Strongbow's got a summer home in Griffin, Georgia.
No kidding.
Near the golf course.
Let him shake everybody's hand. What a phony.
Thank y'all for coming. Certainly appreciate you being here. Waylon Mercy, about 6 feet, 8 inches tall. Somewhere around the 300-pound mark.
You hear what he said? Let me shake your hand. It's nice to meet you. Oh, brother.
Troy Hasty will be challenging the evil Waylon Mercy, big Southern con man.
I don't know what it is.
And boy, have I known a few of them in my time.
I work with one.
Where?
A different job.
Excuse me?
Part-time job. Paper route.
Waylon stepping in the ropes there. Does it want to let the young man gain any momentum whatsoever? And I don't look for that to happen in this contest. I understand Dean Douglas has prepared a critique of sorts regarding the match we saw earlier with the 1-2-3 kid. We'll have that for you in a little bit.
Well, you know, he speaks to us all like we're children, and he's here to raid the superstars of the World Wrestling Federation. He's handing out a lot of Fs.
Troy Hasty may get an F on this one, too. Or an F also.
Yeah, grammatically correct would be also.
Oh, you know, I'm really into that grammatical correctness.
You shouldn't end any sentence with a preposition.
I'm wondering the significance of the very aggressive nature of Waylon Mercy ripping at the shoulder. I'm a little intrigued by all those tattoos because it's obvious that he didn't get that at a licensed and bonded tattoo parlor.
Well, there's no question if Troy was smart, he'd make Hasty get away, far away from Waylon Mercy. That's a play on words.
I did get that and chose to not respond, but be that as it may, Waylon Mercy looking for stiffer competition, and I would like to see him in the ring with maybe a, let's say, a Bret Hart or perhaps even a WWF Championship match with Big Daddy Cool might be interesting.
Now, what do you think Diesel would do? He's got a couple of tattoos, but his are much nicer than this. Waylon Mercy, where'd he get him? Under some bridge?
Well, Diesel's tattoos are store-bought.
That's right.
This, these here look to be the homemade version.
Do you have any?
Absolutely not.
Are you sure?
I'm pretty sure.
Maybe a little smiley face somewhere? Look at that.
Mercy, six, as Granny would say. Waylon Mercy down the sleeper. And that sleeper, very effective, and I guarantee you, you look on this guy's face.
Redemption? What's redemption?
Look at Mercy's face. Can we see that face? Show it. There it is. A dagger on the forehead. That's an evil, evil human being.
The eyes tell the whole story.
Lives are going to be Waylon Mercy's name.
Boy, that gives me the shakes. I got the Jim Jams.
What in the heck are the Jim Jams?
The shivers, the shakes.
Oh, the limber tail.
You need a dictionary. I'm trying to expand your vocabulary.
Look at him. Thank y'all for coming. Drive safely now, you hear?
Sure, now he turns around. Now he's Mr. Sincere.
Well, folks, in 30 seconds, we're going to take you to school.
Brother.
Promotional consideration paid for by the following.
Should be a great one, ladies and gentlemen. This week on Raw, the 7-foot, 317-pound WWF champion will not be fighting for the championship. He'll be fighting for pride. I think Men on a Mission have a big, big plan in store for Diesel.
Well, let's not us talk about it. Let's let Big Daddy do it.
So you got yourself a plan, huh? Sir Mo, tomorrow night, I'm not buying it. King Mabel, you rule the new generation. I got news for you. The World Wrestling Federation is running on diesel power. It's running quite well, thank you. Things don't need to be changed. If you think you could step up to the plate and hit a home run, well, big boy, you go right ahead. SummerSlam. Face the heat. Face Big Daddy Cool. I'm the measuring stick in the World Wrestling Federation. That crown don't mean a thing This belt, that's where it's at. SummerSlam. Face the heat, big boy. Face the heat.
Big Daddy Cool, as always, not backing away from any challenge. He is ready for whatever comes his way.
Won't be too pretty, won't be too scientific this week on Raw. I love that suit. Is that the new Buttafuoco collection?
Stop it.
Very nice.
For Jim Ross, it's Todd Buttafettengill.
Barry Horowitz.
Favorite cartoon.
Yeah. Barry Horowitz himself is a cartoon.
Yeah, the comic strip, Born Loser.
Please. Thank you, boy. You just might be eating your own words if Barry Horowitz pulls out a victory here.
No, I said I think it'll last 10 minutes.
Barry Horowitz. There you have it. 5 minute mark, ladies and gentlemen.
Halfway home, 50 yards.
You got the frustration now. And look at this. Barry Horowitz turns it around on Skip. How about that? Oh, yeah. Put the foot in the back. And look at this. And Barry Horowitz.
Come on. Referee asking for the break. And Skip. Oh, what a hard right hand.
Uh-oh.
Oh, my goodness. Did you see that?
He knocked him out.
Wow. And a few anxious moments on the part of Sonny. And Skip has an opportunity now. Look at this. Sonny imploring Skip to finish the job on Horowitz, who's still in the matchup. Reversal now, coming off the rope. Missing with the roundhouse. Skip on target. Skip takes him down. Skip is gone. Here we go.
Boston Crab.
Boston Crab, that'll do it. Horowitz, a game young man who came into this match trying to last 10 minutes. And
you got to give him credit. It was a good try.
Horowitz is like, wait a minute, he still hasn't given up.
4 minutes remaining.
Matchup. All he has to do is just last 4 more minutes approximately.
Yeah, he needs to go to the outside of the ring. He needs to get on his bike and run. That's what I do.
That's exactly what you would do. But that's not what Barry Horowitz is doing. Look at this. Horowitz firing back. Barry Horowitz, the game young man, coming into this matchup. And wait a minute. Look at this. Skip now has him back in the corner. And Skip pummeling away on Barry Horowitz.
Come on, Skip. Try a backbreaker.
Look at this. Horowitz right in. I can't believe it. Talk about rising to the occasion. Barry Horowitz, ladies and gentlemen, in the matchup and for the ride to the buckle. And here comes Skip right after him. Oh, nobody there.
Ooh.
Nobody home.
He telegraphed that maneuver.
Well, whatever he did, he's in trouble. He being Skip off forearm.
Time's left.
Anything can happen here in the WWF. Under 3 minutes in.
Wow.
Oh, no. Horowitz making a mistake and a right hand by Skip.
Take him to the top. Superplex him.
Don't be telling him what to do. He might hear you.
He should hear me. He should listen to me. I know these things.
Skip isn't listening to Sonny either. Skip, indeed, in control at the moment, but time is running out. Can Horowitz last to the buckle again? And Skip, taking his time out.
Oh, goodness.
Hard right hand. And Skip being warned by the official. Skip could be disqualified here. If he doesn't listen to the official, it's an open hand. He could be disqualified. That'd be a victory for Horowitz. Look at this. Horowitz driving Skip to the corner. Rolls him up.
Oh, no.
He got him.
No, he didn't.
Oh, Black. Look at that maneuver. Now he got him. And a kick out by Skip.
Man, those were too close. Close
and
call.
Barry Horowitz, unquestionably an inspiration.
An
inspiration for so many wrestlers who've struggled for so long in the hopes of one day reaching superstar status. And Horowitz, if he can just hang in there for a couple more minutes. Oh, no, 1, 2, and the kick out.
He kicked out. How could he not hook the leg? How come he hasn't taken him up to the top and done the superplex?
Look at Horowitz, wise now, going to the outside. That's all he has to do.
Oh, no.
Right back in. And Skip, the time is running out for Skip. Skip, who vowed he was going to defeat Horowitz in 1 minute. And there cover, 1, 2, and then a kick out again by Horowitz. And obviously, Skip very, very frustrated. Horowitz wisely going to the outside again, stalling.
Skip's out of his game plan. He's not doing the basics.
And Horowitz right on his game plan indeed. Keep running. Keep running, Barry. That's all you got to do. And look at this. We're down to 1 minute. One.
That's
the jaws of victory.
Oh, so cute. So cute.
Barry Horace making a living off beating Skip. I got a feeling, Todd, these guys will meet again.
Ladies and gentlemen, still to come here this week, the World Wrestling Federation champion Diesel locking up with Sermo.
We'll show you highlights. Stay with us.
Hey, welcome back to the Action Zone. I'm here with my friends Doug and Deb, and they're playing Madcaps. As a matter of fact, they won't even give them back to me. So I'm going to have to talk to you today about something a little bit different. This is Madcaps, but it's brought to you in uncut sheet form. You know that this item is not available to you anywhere else but by dialing 1-800-TITAN-91. Now, for only $19, you get a full uncut sheet of set one, a complete set, 66 Madcaps, and you also get the 18-karat gold-plated slammer and the neoprene board to play the game on come along in this collection. You know, uncut sheets are extremely rare. As a matter of fact, you can't find them anywhere else. But you know me, they call me the deal maker, guys, and here comes the deal. Right here, WWF Magazine. Now, everybody loves to read it, and if you want to get a free 3-month subscription, that's right, free 3-month subscription, just dial 1-800-TITAN-91, and it comes along as part of this package. For only $19, you get the uncut sheet, the 18-karat gold plated slammer, the neoprene board, and the magazine for 3 months absolutely free. Back to you guys.
Barry, that's 18-karat gold. Ever hear of Hooked on Phonics?
Jean-Pierre Lafitte is hooked on victories. He is undefeated in the World Wrestling Federation. But that could change very soon.
Well, I don't understand something. You know, of course, the pirate creed is against all flags, but he's carrying a flag. I mean, I know it's a skull and crossbones, but it's still a flag.
But, and it has his image neatly immersed in that skull and crossbones.
Well, he'll lock up with Jerry Faith here this afternoon in the Action Zone. And I've got faith that he's going to go down to defeat right now, right here, today on the Action Zone.
Well, I'll tell you something. He may get that opportunity because the World Wrestling Federation tonight will be in Albany, New York at Knickerbocker Arena.
Beautiful arena right downtown.
I have been there many times and a lot of great fans in Albany. That'll be tonight. And speaking of the WWF Tour de Force, we'll be live in Bangor, Maine on Wednesday.
Oh, that's beautiful.
And on Friday night in the Palace of Auburn Hills right outside.
Oh, my gosh!
Right outside Detroit. And that's where that double sledge came from, it looked like.
He just walked the plank.
Jerry Faith better keep it. The faith, that is, because Pierre is not in a very pleasant mood here this week on the Zone.
Well, he never is. Man, he is powerful.
Clubbing away at Jerry Faith is this very, very gifted athlete who has that bona fide mean streak. And now Faith trying to go for a crucifix. And look at the power of Pierre. Hoisting Faith up on his shoulders and drills him to the canvas.
Oh, man! You know, in addition to being a very gifted WWF superstar, he's a thief.
You're right.
I mean, we saw him stealing that head from Hakushi, taking Brett glasses from a fan last weekend. Anything happens with this guy, he just takes it.
He's had more hits in this match already than Daryl Strawberry has for the Yankees so far this summer. And up and over, and he landed on his feet. Unbelievable. Chest of Jerry Faith, and Pierre obviously likes inflicting pain on his opponents.
It's Emilio Estevez ringside.
Was it really?
Yeah, with the hat. I gotta get down there, get an autograph. You never know who shows up at the World Wrestling Federation live.
Oh, man. Gosh. Well, that'll dim your old running lights right there. Referee Earl Hebner taking a look at this opponent.
Jerry Faith is gonna resent stepping into that.
Todd, are you online?
Excuse me?
Are you online?
Oh, America Online?
Yeah.
Of course I am.
You know, ladies and gentlemen, America Online is the official online service of the World Wrestling Federation. And
yes.
The WWF site will be online before SummerSlam. If you'd like more information, we encourage you to call 1-800-916-9966. And please dial carefully.
You get 10 free online hours. Now, that's very cool.
It's not too cool. For the Jerry Faith Fan Club.
I want to send you some email. What's your screen name?
Oh, gosh, right over the top. That's not my screen name.
Oh, gosh.
Right over the top. But it could
be. Too many letters. You only get 8.
Oh, well. I'll tell you something. Pierre has looked very impressive. I'm not a big fan of this guy's philosophy. You know, who likes a thief? But boy, he is a gifted athlete.
Like you could be OG over the T.
Look at him get his head of steam. And Jerry Faith all tied up and nowhere to go. Jean-Pierre Lafitte, very, very effective. And there's a running DDT. Boy, it's great seeing these young superstars in the WWF. And that's one of the great things about the World Wrestling Federation. So many young, upcoming superstars. You know, it's not like watching the AMC channel, American Movie Classics, the old stuff.
Black and white.
Yeah.
That's old generation. This is new WWF generation. Look at this. Little cannonball, baby.
Little cannonball.
Little cannonball. Let's go.
70 pounds, the 360 in midair, very impressive. I don't care if you are Bret the Hitman Hart, you've got to beware of this guy. He's going right to the top.
Well, he landed on Jerry Faith's mouth there. Maybe he needs a trip to the dentist. We'll take one of those trips when we come back.
Promotional consideration paid for by the following.
Well, Lawler's got a lot of problems on his hands. His breath's just one of them. Tomorrow night on Monday Night Raw, he'll have probably another huge problem with Shawn Michaels, but that's another story.
Indeed. Supersize Stride X pads present SummerSlam. That's what the Insider is here to talk about. And check this out. You will see the legendary pink and black, the Hitman, taking on Isaac Yankem, DDS.
My sources tell me that Brett is very concerned about this matchup simply because he has no videotape to study Yankem. He doesn't know exactly where Yankem's strengths or his weaknesses lie. Brett had a few comments to make, as a matter of fact, ladies and gentlemen. Seemed to be pretty confident, but take it from me, he's very concerned.
You know, with SummerSlam only 2 weeks away, I tend to take things just a little more serious. Isaac Yankem, DDS. You know, I don't know if you're really a dentist or what. I don't even know if you're a great wrestler. Maybe secretly, you're a great wrestler. Well, I'm not going to leave anything to doubt. I'm going to go in there in the SummerSlam, and I'm going to knock your teeth out. I'm going to drill your face so many times that you'll be sorry that you ever connected yourself with Jerry Lawler in the first place. In the SummerSlam, the Hitman will dispose of the Tooth Fairy. See you in the SummerSlam, punk.
What is with this guy, Dean Douglas?
Very educated.
Oh, watch out! Oh.
Duck! Incoming!
I don't know anything about his background. Does he have a master's? Does he have a doctorate?
He's got a master's, yes.
Does he have a PhD?
Not quite, but ours toward that degree. He has been admitted to medical school.
Does he have a BA? I know he has a BS.
And he's a very, very talented athlete. Speaking of talented athletes, there's one, and the British Bulldog, Davey Boy Smith, or so is his tag team partner, Lex Luger. They say that they are the most powerful tag team in the history of the WWF.
Well, we'll see. They're competitors here this afternoon in the Action Zone. Bob Cook and A.C. Connor may have something to say about that. They're going to try and defeat the Allied Powers.
Allied Powers still looking for that elusive WWF Tag Team Championship gold. Will they ever get their hands on the championship belts currently held by the awesome Yokozuna and Owen Hart?
We've said it before, they're probably the most talented superstars without gold. We'll get to the matchup in 30 seconds.
Promotional consideration paid for by the following.
Welcome to Nerf Max Force. It starts with a flurry of 15 darts off in a hurry, muscled by the crank of Razor Beast. Max Force, it's Nerf to the next power.
Slick 50 protects the vital moving parts of your engine for up to 50,000 miles. Slick 50 starting your engine with that is a terrible thing to do.
Two men enter the future with one mission. Destroy the other first. Armed with awesome firepower, battle through 10 intense levels straight from this movie mega hit. Demolition Man, the future's only hope from Acclaim.
And we're ready to go here. It'll be Bob Cook and Lex Luger for their respective duos. Folks, don't forget the WWF Superstar Line is open 7 days a week, 24 hours a day. The number is 1-900-737-4WWF. It's only $1.49 per minute, and the billing doesn't begin until you choose your option. And kids, doggone it, be sure you're 18 years of age or have your parents' permission before calling. On option 6 today, a conversation I had with Psycho Sid. You'll hear Sid say what he's going to do to Shawn Michaels tomorrow night on Raw. And I asked him about the Million Dollar Man. You won't believe what Psycho Sid said about his boss. That's on option 6.
Well, I'll tell you, it certainly sounds hot. I would check it out, option 6 on the WWF Superstar Line.
Lex Luger side headlock on Bob Cook, the veteran from the Sunshine State of Florida. And Luger scooping up Cook and slams him with a great deal of authority.
Doesn't look like he gets out in it much.
No, I don't think Cook's a sun person. And Cook with a handful of tights. Trying to take a little shortcut there on Lex Luger.
Is he albino?
Luger? No, I think he's Democrat.
No, Bob Cook.
I don't think so. Floridian.
Never mind.
Luger is a little frustrated about this championship situation.
He better put Copper Tone 90 on that skin.
And Luger trying to roll up Cook, and Cook holds on to the... Oh, look at the great agility of Lex Luger.
Look at that!
And Luger tags him with a clothesline.
Surprise, surprise, surprise!
Cook, the flip box, and flies to the corner and gets a tag to A.C. Connor.
Very nice alliteration.
Thank you.
Welcome.
Connor with right hands on the powerful British Bulldog.
Whoa!
First heel kick by Connor. Yeah. A little too early to celebrate there, A.C. AC rather vociferous this week.
Why is he screaming?
I don't know. A little aggressive.
There we go. The British Bulldog now.
Well, this will take the aggressiveness out of one. But face lock. And Connor thinking about it. He's upside down. The British Bulldog with a great display of strength and drops him in the suplex. The British Bulldog and the legendary Dynamite Kid were the WWF Tag Team Champions. And Davey Boy has been the Intercontinental Champion, and he is doing all he can. Oh, Battle Press could be all right here. Yeah, no, it's not. I'll tell you something. Davey has done a great job in keeping Lex focused because Davey knows, Todd, what it's like to be a champion in the WWF.
And these guys are due for greatness. They're such a great team, but still have not got that goal.
And they have so much in common. When their schedule permits, they train at least twice a day, at least once a day, every day. They're in the gymnasium. They travel together. They're inseparable. They really think as one. And maybe it will be just a matter of time until they wrestle the tag team championship away from Yokozuna. And Owen Hart, and nobody's there. And Connor, he may have struck his head on the ring post.
Like he was on a rubber band. Man.
Uh-oh, rubber band man. He's a rubber band man here. And there's that brilliant power slam. That will be all she wrote. Cliche one, cliche two, Katie bar the door.
What? What is wrong with you?
I don't know. I think I'm feverish.
You want an aspirin?
I need an aspirin. Folks, get your pencil and paper handy. We're going to tell you how you can get involved in the World Wrestling Federation with some very important fundraisers.
Actually, maybe I should get you a Tylenol. It's better for your stomach.
I've been upset since the passing of Jerry Garcia. I just haven't been myself.
Yeah, that's unreal, isn't it?
Absolutely unreal. And so is that combination right there. Lex Luger, Davey Boy Smith, the Allied Powers want the gold. And now, ladies and gentlemen, here's that address we're telling you about. A limited number of fundraisers are available. Just you're right, the World Wrestling Federation, Post Office Box 3857, Stamford, Connecticut 06902. Attention fundraisers. We'd like to support you and your organization. The WWF superstars you see right here on TV can appear in your hometown. Welcome back, everybody, to The Zone. Tomorrow night, a huge night right here on USA on Monday Night Raw when Jerry the King Lawler goes nose-to-nose with Shawn Michaels. And I can guarantee you, Lawler will not come alone or Todd without a plan.
Listen to the Burger King.
Everybody's concerned about the health of Shawn Michaels. What's the matter, Shawn? Feeling a little under the weather? Huh? Well, what King Mabel did to you was just a start. King Lawler is going to finish you. Tomorrow night on Monday Night Raw, I'm going to break the Heartbreak Kid in half.
What is that with breaking in half? I mean, that's not right. What's Jerry Lawler doing?
Well, he's talking a lot, as usual. Lawler will have a plan this week on Raw, as we said. Lawler will probably not come alone. And remember, Psycho Sid is irate at Shawn Michaels. Sid thinks that Shawn is the one that convinced President Gorilla Monsoon to change the matchup, the Intercontinental title at SummerSlam.
Well, anything can happen in the World Wrestling Federation, and probably will. That's it for us this week. For Jim Ross, it's Todd Pesky. We'll see you.
The World Wrestling Federation, for over 50 years, the revolutionary force in sports entertainment. We'll be right back.
welcome everyone to the Action Zone. Todd Pesgill along with Jim Ross with an incredible broadcast lined up for you this week. We are going to hear from the 568-pound King Mabel.
The man that may be the next WWF champion, Todd, at SummerSlam, and we're not that far away, just about a week.
Also, how about the slop drop? You're going to see Henry Godwin pour it all over the $1 million man.
And that Armani suit was not Scotchgarden.
How about the huge news announced over the weekend regarding the Undertaker and Kama at SummerSlam?
We'll talk more about that. I don't think Kama or the Million Dollar Man are going to like this news. This has not been a good week for the Million Dollar Man.
Also, the Heartbreak Kid, Shawn Michaels, locking up with the Big Mouth Jerry Lawler. You will see it all on the Action Zone this afternoon. It is going to be an absolutely huge broadcast. How's your cold?
Not very well, but I'm going to hang in there.
Well, I got the perfect home remedy for you.
Boy, I need something. I've been eating a lot of chicken soup.
Don't do chicken soup.
Really?
No, that's for fever.
Oh, gosh.
I got a salve for you.
Well, I think Mark Thomas may need a salve here. Savio Vega takes him down again with that big head scissors. And Savio, one more time, going to the air. Air Vega. Not to be confused with Ground Gremlin.
Yeah, thank you very much. It's running great. Thanks for asking. I got a guy upstate New York near Albany.
Yeah?
Makes the best salve.
Cold salve.
No, it's warm. You heat it.
Oh,
oh, but it's far cold, yeah. You're confusing me.
I'm confused now. I think I'm delirious with this fever.
Oh!
Mark Thomas now trying to drop kick and got one foot on Savio. Thomas, a muscular young competitor here in the WWF.
What a broadcast we have. You're going to see Whale and Mercy. The Smoking Guns will be here this week. Really great broadcast.
If I were Mark Thomas, I wouldn't try to climb the ropes anymore.
Little dance in there from Savio.
You must be dancing.
You're feeling good this week, aren't you?
I feel great. I hope I don't catch your cold.
Maybe that's what I need, a big chop there from Savio to break up the congestion.
Sure it's not the swine flu? That's going around again.
I hope not.
If you get that, you just die.
DiBiase's got a case of the swine flu after that slop.
Yes!
Snapmare over by Savio Vega. And Savio going for a submission here. Savio Vega with that submission maneuver on Mark Thomas.
Boy, he is fun to watch. The epitome of the new WWF generation is Savio Vega.
He turned him on in the garden about a week ago now. Sidewalk slander by Savio Vega. It's a finish.
Finito!
Savio Vega, spinning heel kick. Caught him right in the jaw, did Savio Vega. And Vega has won it here.
SummerSlam. The countdown is on from the World Wrestling Federation. The hottest night of the summer is only a week away.
The heat wave continues with no relief in sight. Record high temperatures.
SummerSlam?
Sure.
Yes, it's going to be another.
Funny, for a moment there, I felt young again. Like, where'd Martha go?
Take a ride with Diesel when Supersized Stridex Pads presents SummerSlam live August 27th on pay-per-view.
Yes, folks, Supersized Stridex Pads present SummerSlam from the sold-out Igloo in Pittsburgh. You talk about exciting, the countdown is on. As a matter of fact, let's get right into it, Jim Ross, and talk about that WWF Championship matchup between Big Daddy Cool Diesel and the 568-pound King Mabel.
Well, nobody has been more devastating in the last few weeks than King Mabel. At 6 feet 8, 568 pounds, he will be no doubt Diesel's biggest challenge to date. We said it once, we'll say it again. There's no way Diesel's going to be able to jackknife this big man.
Now, I believe we have King Mabel and Sir Mo standing by. Guys, if we could just ask you a couple of questions. Can we
what do you want, peasant?
Well, we just wanted to ask you a couple of questions about SummerSlam.
Let me make one thing perfectly clear. I'm the king around here. I ask the questions, and I also give the answers.
Fine.
It's already been two times, Big Daddy Fool, that you've fallen into my royal plan. The first time was that in your house. How's that back feel? And as far as Monday Night Raw, Shawn Michaels, your little girly boy, well, he went down too. This Monday night on Raw. The plan will unfold just a little bit more. And you will see why. When I say I'm going to be the champion, I tell the truth.
Long live the king.
Sort of doesn't lack for confidence, does he?
Long live the king, if you can get a word in to ask him.
Gosh, I'll tell you. Well, this is going to be quite a contest. Absolutely huge at SummerSlam, but we've got some heat stuff coming up, too.
Indeed, folks, we're going to take you back to Raw last week and show you that matchup between Shawn Michaels and Jerry Lawler.
It's obvious that Razor Ramon and Shawn Michaels will be more than ready for SummerSlam. Let's hear comments from Shawn Michaels, but first, from the bad guy.
In a world full of plow horses, the WWF's two premier thoroughbreds gonna meet one more time. A ladder match. Anything could happen. It's so unpredictable. Just like Razor Ramon. With the ladder, chicos, nobody knows what's gonna happen. But Michaels, everybody knows what happened last time.
The ladder match in 94. The greatest match in World Wrestling Federation history. Until now. The ladder match in 95 is far going to exceed the other. And Razor Ramon, I am sick of you and everybody else giving me the history lesson about what happened last time. Nobody knows better than me. I was the one falling 20 feet and hitting the mat. But this time, things are going to be different. Nothing in the world is going to keep me from climbing that ladder and claiming what is rightfully mine.
Tempers flaring and both superstars obviously 100% focused. Intercontinental title on the line. Shawn Michaels and Razor Ramon in a ladder match. When we come back on the Action Zone, the Southern Gentleman Waylon Mercy.
You know what I mean?
Lives are going to be in Waylon Mercy's hands.
Quite a showdown this week on Raw between The Undertaker and Tatanka. And here comes the old Southern Gentleman. And we use that term loosely.
Well, I tell you, this guy seems to snap once in a while in the ring, just like Bob Backlund did a year ago. You remember when he faced Bret Hart?
Yeah.
I mean, Bob is now campaigning while he's considering a run for the presidency. And as far as I know, Waylon Mercy is not considering running for anything, including running for cover. I mean, he just gets an opponent in the ring, and he goes right at him.
Look at this guy. He's about as insincere as anyone you'll ever meet. But we can say this, he's undefeated. Big man, about 6 feet, 8 inches tall.
Those tattoos are bizarre.
They're ugly.
Well, one's a dagger, one says redemption, I do believe. And look at him. He's shaking the referee's hand. Look at the size of him next to the referee.
That one tattoo, torment. That's what Waylon Mercy has done to his opponents. Will he do it to Tony Roy? Roy, you better be careful, Roy boy. And Waylon Mercy with that clothesline from the left side. You got it.
Tony shake his hand.
Well, it obviously speaks for the intelligence, perhaps, of Tony Roy. Should have done a little bit better job in preparing to meet this evil monster from down south of the Mason-Dixon line.
Well, Waylon Mercy now got a handful of that Michael Bolton, Tony Roy hair.
Hard chop there by Waylon Mercy. It's going to be interesting to see how this guy will fare when he steps in the ring with the likes of a Diesel, perhaps, or a Bret the Hitman Hart.
I just realized who Tony Roy reminds me of.
And who might that be, Toster?
Gallagher.
Well,
all he needs is those giant roller skates, that big chair.
And we would need the trash bags.
That's right. You don't sit in the front row, the watermelon might hit you.
Or we could look like the Million Dollar Man did.
Oh, how about that?
When he was slopped.
Gotta help him.
Yeah, don't bet on it. Don't bet the farm on this one. For a guy like that one time, a clever manipulator. And boy, I tell you what, Tony Roy can't even get up. He's been counted out, and Waylon Mercy remains undefeated.
result of the countdown, Whalen Mercy.
You know, Jim Ross, there's a very interesting article Whalen Mercy is in the WWF magazine entitled New Kids on the Block. Where do you read about it?
We're not talking about Donnie Wahlberg now, are we?
No, totally different group.
Shawn Michaels is on the cover of that magazine, on sale nationwide.
Look at this guy.
I don't like this guy.
Was he going to try to help him up again? Didn't think he helped Tony Roy enough? Yeah, you're sorry.
He has no remorse. He has no conscience.
Thank you very much.
Promotional consideration paid for by the following.
Didn't you? Well, there go Henry. Henry Godwin has some newfound popularity here in the World Wrestling Federation.
I wouldn't be surprised if the Million Dollar Man burned through a couple of $200,000-$300,000 worth of shampoo. Wash, rinse, and repeat. A lot of corn laying in the drain.
Yes, sir. Henry Godwin turned his back on Mike Bell. Oh, Mike Bell is kind of fired up here this week.
Supposed to wait for the bell.
No one told him. Oh, look at the velocity there. Good grief. Henry Godwin sent Bell for one heck of a ride.
Henry was on a pig drive this morning.
A pig drive?
Yeah, you know, you got to drive them like cattle.
Now, I didn't know that, and I grew up on a farm.
Well, I read that somewhere.
National Geo?
No, Ripley's.
Bell with the right hand there on the 300-pound hog farmer from Bitters, Arkansas, who apparently wasn't made of the right stuff. Didn't have the refined upbringing. Didn't have the class and the culture necessary to be a member of the Million Dollar Corporation. At least that was apparently DiBiase's take on it.
I guess you're right, but Ted DiBiase was hand-grooming this guy.
Two and a near fall.
I mean, what happened? Ted DiBiase knew that all along. He must have found out something about Henry Godwin.
I think DiBiase's a user. I think he knew all along he wasn't going to hire Henry Godwin or to make him a... Oh, my goodness, what a move. Make him a full-time employee of the Million Dollar Corporation.
And Henry Godwin, of course, has his eyes on all that cash and the cars and the money. I mean, he was believing he was actually going to be let into that exclusive corporation.
Folks, let us remind you of the WWF Superstar line. The number is 1-900-737-4WWF. It's only $1.49 per minute. Now, remember, it's open 24 hours a day, 7 days a week. And, kids, you got to have your parents' permission before calling. On option six, we'll tell you why a lot of people think that diesel will cost Shawn Michaels the Intercontinental title at SummerSlam.
One, two, and no. Mike Bell kicking out.
And we'll tell you just exactly the unique training methods that Razor Ramon is using to get ready for the ladder match. That and much more right now on option six.
And Henry Godwin working on the left arm of Mike Bell in total control here this afternoon on the Action Zone.
Tell me more about this new format here on the Action Zone. I didn't know a lot about that.
You haven't had your audition?
No. No, I'm ready, though. I'm available.
Is your phone hooked up?
Oh, yeah. Uh-oh. Mike Bell's phone is ringing. The bells are ringing from that slop drop. And the Million Dollar Man will never forget this week after he was hit right in the face with that big old bucket of slop. And hey, Henry's not going to do it to Mike Bell, too, is he?
I don't know. He just might. He's throwing it on everybody.
The crowd's going to start chanting slop drop, slop drop, slop drop. Henry. Oh, Henry, don't do it. Henry, say it ain't so. Right in the kisser.
Oh, man. Well, maybe Mike Bell didn't have lunch. He just did.
Oh. Henry Godwin, no doubt, will become a marked man.
I feel ill.
As far as the Million Dollar Corporation is concerned. What's a Pepto?
Beg your pardon?
Pepto.
No, you know what? It leaves a bad taste in my mouth.
I mean, kind of like going to the dentist office.
Back on the Zone and Jim and Todd's excellent adventure.
And folks, we're going to take you back to this past weekend's WWF Superstars. Kama had a one-on-one matchup. And as many of you know, Gorilla Monsoon has now ordered that Kama and The Undertaker's one-on-one confrontation at SummerSlam to be a casket match. A lot of you are wondering why that ruling was made. It happened at the end of this matchup. Take you back to Superstars. Doc Hendricks, along with Vince McMahon, called the act.
Where do you see this?
There he is, the Supreme Fighting Machine. And behind Kama, the man on the receiving end of the slot drop. Yeah, the million-dollar man, Ted DiBiase.
And he is hot, Doc.
Everybody, yes, he is. And I got a feeling Mr. Bert Centeno is going to have to feel the repercussions of Mr. Henry O. Godwin's slop attack this past week on Raw. DiBiase is not going to stand for it. There's going to be a retaliation.
On Ted DiBiase, despite the humiliation this past week on Raw, has to have one thing on his mind as it relates to Kama and SummerSlam, and that, of course, is a one-on-one encounter with The Undertaker. What an awesome matchup! Centeno! Wow, to the buckle. We saw Kama earlier on before the match began take off that necklace of shortness. Yes, there's a wreath planted there by the creatures of the night. Fans of The Undertaker. Centeno, ooh, to the buckle. You know, Kama melting down the urn. Imagine that, when he was handed the urn, melted it down and made a necklace of it. That takes some guts.
Yeah, but you have to imagine how important that urn is to The Undertaker. Still, he has yet, you know, to really get on the Kama and do the things that he's done to everybody else.
Oh, nobody there. Centeno with an opportunity now. Brett Centeno with a right hand, clipping a jaw, and another one. Centeno firing off a series of rights out, setting up the Supreme Fighting Machine. Kama with a reversal. Off the rope, and a back body drop.
You know, he can't stand them creatures of the night, and one of these days, bringing them black briefs, they're going to go too far. They're going to step over the line, buddy.
I don't know about that. He'll be enjoying themselves out about ringside for weeks and weeks. Off the rope, and wow!
Whoa!
What was that?
That was called...
What is that?
Yeah, exactly. And hey, think about this. I told you about the plan unfolded last week on Raw about Psycho Sid and about King Jerry Lawler. Well, let me tell you about this week. Oh, it's The Undertaker against Tatanka. And if you think they ain't going to soften him up before SummerSlam, then grits ain't groceries and eggs ain't
Look at that! And a cover! Now hook in the right hand, the three count.
He's ready. He is ready.
Yes, ladies and gentlemen. One-on-one, Tatanka against The Undertaker. And again, Tom, I'll be rating some of The Undertaker fans about ringside, as we've seen many times before.
Well, who can blame him now?
Tom, I'm ripping that black wig to the shreds. Tom, hey, wait.
Oh, yeah, like he's going to do something. What's he doing? Has he lost his mind?
I don't know. Ted DiBiase smiling at the moment. He certainly was a problem. Wait a minute. What's going on here? This young man,
my buddy, your day late, the dollar short,
is picking up the remnants of the wreath that Kama just tore apart.
Oh,
it's not advisable. This is not a good sign. Kama.
Oh, here we go. Here we go.
Bad news. Oh, my goodness, Kama attacking the... Look at that! What's going on? Kama holding that man up and driving him down the canvas! A man had no reason!
He's making him eat it! They look a little hungry anyway. Look a little undernourished.
And I would suggest that things have really gotten out of hand here. Undertaker fans about ringside, Doc.
Hey, what's up? Hey. Messing with their mics.
And a bit of a supernatural, if you would.
Freezing.
This young lady is coming over the railing. And this is not a good sign for this young man who came over the railing into the ring, something that someone should never do in attending a WWF event. We'll be back, ladies and gentlemen, as we continue with more action.
Oh, well, win some, lose some.
Not funny. All right, folks.
folks. Welcome back. We are due to bring you up to speed on SummerSlam and the awesome card. However, before we do that, we got to tell them what's going on Saturday before SummerSlam in Pittsburgh.
Big tug of war.
What?
Big tug of war.
Yeah.
Some of the great firefighters from Pittsburgh and some superstars from the World Wrestling Federation. Some big superstars will be getting it on, near some body of water.
Yeah, it's going to be called the War on the Water, a big tug of war, and proceeds from each ticket sold is going to the Pittsburgh Firefighters Monument Fund.
Great cause.
So it really is a great cause.
Great cause, and of course, that's on the eve of SummerSlam in Pittsburgh, and of course, we're pumped about this. This is going to be something in Pittsburgh.
Let's talk about the excellence of execution, the hitman Bret Hart locking up with a man we saw earlier on. Took a visit to the dentist's office, Isaac Yankum, DDS.
He doesn't look like Bucky Beaver, the Ipana poster boy, does he?
He certainly does
not. Ugly teeth, big man, and Bret Hart is concerned about this guy's size. Now, Bret has a lot of bravado. Bret's a great athlete, maybe the greatest WWF champion of all time. At least he is, in my opinion. But I'll tell you something. I think Bret has some concerns about the size of Dr. Yankum, who is at least as large as Psycho Sid.
Ladies and gentlemen, the excellence of execution, Bret Hart.
You know, Jerry Lawler, you've really outdone yourself this time. Just because you were forced to kiss my feet and yours at the King of the Ring, you ran out and got somebody else to fight your battles for you. A demented tooth fairy by the name of Isaac Yankum, DDS. Well, Yankum, if you want an appointment with the Hitman, step right up. If you like pain, then at the SummerSlam, you're going to be in seventh heaven. Bring all the Novocaine that you can get your little grubby gloves on, because you're going to need it. And by the way, bring along that diabolical hygienist of yours just for the fun of it.
Well, nobody likes to go to the dentist, but the Hitman is not afraid.
One thing's for sure, Todd. Jerry Lawler will be at ringside in some shape, form, or fashion. I'm sure he'll be on the broadcast team with Vince McMahon, but you can't trust the King, speaking of Jerry Lawler.
Now, let's talk about another title on the line at SummerSlam. You will see the WWF Women's Championship go up for grabs. Alundra Blaze defends the gold against the woman who broke her nose back in April. And that, of course, is Bertha Faye.
Isn't Bertha Faye a vision of loveliness? Got to be 250, ladies and gentlemen. Of course, her little boyfriend, Harvey Whippleman, may be 130 soaking wet. And Alundra has never forgotten what Bertha Faye did to her on Raw. It's going to be a good match.
Bertha's a Malox moment in a dress. Mm. All right, now let's talk about yet another matchup, and we alluded to it earlier on. The casket match now between The Undertaker and the Million Dollar Corporation's Kama.
And Gorilla Monsoon, the interim president of the WWF, has informed me that he will have the double deep, double wide casket at ringside for this one. This is going to be a monumental matchup. And remember, The Undertaker has only lost one casket match in his entire career.
And that means The Undertaker and Paul Bearer are looking to claim yet another soul for the dark side.
Oh,
silence.
No.
Until now, Kama, I have kept all my emotions in check. You have attacked me. You have stole my urn. And you have defiled it. You wear it as cheap jewelry. But now you have stepped over the boundaries of what I can accept. I am the chosen one, the protectors of the creatures. And your attack on my creatures of the night sealed your fate. Come SummerSlam, when I shut that casket on you, believe me, you will rest in peace.
So much for the dead calm of The Undertaker. He'll be ready in 1 week.
And supersized Stridex pads proudly present SummerSlam. As Jim Ross said, 1 week away. 1 week from tonight, the sold-out Igloo in Pittsburgh, 7 o'clock Eastern, 4 Pacific, exclusively on pay-per-view. Folks, when we come back, just 30 seconds away, you'll get a look at Gold Dust.
Ooh. Promotional consideration paid for by the following.
Welcome to Nerf Max Force. It starts with a flurry, 15 darts off in a hurry, muscled by the crank of Razor Beast. Max Force, it's Nerf to the next power.
Slick 50 protects the vital moving parts of your engine for up to 50,000 miles. Slick 50 starting your engine without is a terrible thing to do.
Feel the heavyweight power of Foreman for real. This intense boxing game is a knockout with ultra-realistic motion capture graphics, 20 tough boxers, and Big George himself. Step into the ring with Foreman for real from Acclaim.
Hollywood. Land of the stars, the home place of the rich.
A corner of the world in Southern California where dreams are made and lives are shattered. Many people have come into this magical town and made quite a name for themselves. You got Dean. And you got Bogart. And you're Keg. You're Peck. The Tinseltown roll call goes on and on and on. However, there is a difference between these stars and the legend. The gold dust. You see, these celluloid gods and goddesses were fabricated. They were cloned into stardom by teams of writers, producers, and directors. Spend many summer days in acting 101. That's the difference. And that is the difference. Look into my eyes. That is the difference between them. You see, I was born a star. It was a gift from that great one in the sky. No editing, just pure talent.
Folks, the Action Zone is being brought to you this week by new, bigger Stridex medicated pads. It's simple pimple control.
Well, what do you think about Goldust, Hawk?
Well, I'll tell you the truth, I don't know what to think. I'll tell you what, I know Billy and Bart Gunn have never seen anything like him in Texas down on a farm.
I don't think anybody from Texas has ever seen anything like Goldust.
No, you're right.
Goldust will be making his in-ring debut in the next few weeks here in the WWF. And Billy and Bart will renew their rivalry with Jacob and Eli Blue at SummerSlam in what is a very important rankings match as far as the WWF tag team titles are concerned.
Of course, the Smoking Guns, having held that title before, I would think would have to have a slight advantage over the bigger Eli and Jacob Blue.
Couple of brother teams, identical twins, Jacob and Eli, and Billy and Bart Gunn, gearing up for SummerSlam, and the young combination of Brian Walsh and Jeff Hardy. It's Brian Walsh and Billy Gunn kicking it off here, side shoulder block there by Billy Gunn. These Smoking Guns are lightning quick, and a nice move there by Brian Walsh. Walsh, high elevation.
Boy, look at the height.
And another arm drag takeover by Billy Gunn.
Am I confused, or is that neon green?
I think you hit the nail on the head.
Looks like one of Vince McMahon's suits.
Or one of Isaac Yankum's teeth, but be that as it may. Hey, you know, Vince McMahon's going to be on America Online this week after Raw.
Do tell.
America Online, if you want more information, you can call 1-800-916-9966.
Oh!
Brian Walsh has taken it to Billy Gunn. Billy Gunn crashed his face right in the canvas, and then Walsh caught him with that clothesline. And now Walsh and Jeff Hardy,
one of the Hardy boys,
will do some double teaming here, it would seem. And taken again, Billy Gunn face first, right down to the canvas.
Billy's got to be wondering what's going on here.
Jeff Hardy needs to wrestle and not fight here.
Uh-oh, big mistake.
Billy Gunn taking Hardy down rather uniquely with a leg. Smoking Guns, deceivingly large. 6'5" tall, about 270 pounds each.
And now Bart Gunn firing away on Jeff Hardy for the rope and that big elbow.
Hard elbow right to the sternum, finding its mark. Two great representatives of the new generation.
Look at that elevation. That's like going down an elevator shaft.
Another great drop kick there. World Wrestling Federation with so many young superstars comprising the foundation for the future of the WWF. And there's a tag. Double side Russian leg sweep by the Smoking Guns.
It's teamwork like that that I believe is going to propel these guys to the number one contenders for the World Wrestling Federation Tag Team Championship.
Another tag made I'm sure Yokozuna and Owen Hart will get a tape of this contest as they, under the leadership of James E., the Prince of Polyester Cornette, and Mr. Fuji, always have to keep an eye on their competition. And Billy Gunn and Bart Gunn with great teamwork. What a maneuver and what a victory for the Smoking Guns here this week on the Zone. And again, let me remind you, everybody, that Vince McMahon will be on America Online tomorrow night, right after Monday Night Raw. If you like 10 free hours of service on America Online, call 1-800-916-9966. A unique opportunity to chat with Vince McMahon tomorrow night after Raw.
World Wrestling Federation, for over 50 years, the revolutionary force in sports entertainment.
Welcome to the Action Zone. I'm Jim Ross alongside Todd Pettengill, and indeed we are just hours away from SummerSlam, exclusively on pay-per-view, and the big mountain men, Jacob and Eli Blue, are not only ready for the guns later today at SummerSlam, they're ready right here, right now, Todd.
I'll tell you what, Jim, I am so excited about SummerSlam, but still I can't get off my mind what happened on Raw with the British Bulldog David Smith and this royal plan of King Mabel's and Sir Mo's.
Well, and apparently the royal plan hasn't played itself out yet, and we're going to be talking more about the royal plan that no doubt another card in that royal plan will be played later tonight at SummerSlam.
All right, here's a quarter. Heads or tails?
Tails.
Tails, it's Eli. Heads, it's Jacob. Tails.
Well, it's Eli. Or is it Jacob?
I think it's Eli.
Well, Eli and Jason Arndt kicking it off here. Your referee is Jack Doan. Capacity crowd on hand, and a good power slam there by Jacob and Eli Blue.
These guys are awesome. You don't want to make too many mistakes against Jacob and Eli Blue. Look at this.
Big, rugged individuals will not beat you with technique. They muscle their opponents. They overpower the athletes that they are in the ring with. And a foot right to the face. And they remind me of a great athlete many, many years ago, the late Bruiser Brody, that wild hair, that big, big frame.
Speaking of wild hair, we're going to talk to Shawn Michaels, hopefully a little later on in the Action Zone. Also, Doc Hendricks will be talking with, oh, man, the Hitman, Bret Hart.
Man. We told you about these guys coming from every direction in the squared circle. They come off the ropes. They use their feet. They use their forearms, just, again, manhandling their opponents. And there's a tag mate. We'll see how Matt Hardy will fare against Jacob or Eli. Hardy comes off the top rope to no avail.
Yeah, these guys are absolutely unhurtable. I mean, how do you injure these guys? How do you go after them? What's the strategy against these two mountain men?
Jacob and Eli, 6'9", 320 pounds.
Man.
And just raw power, and Billy and Bart Gunn.
I mean, the devastation is really unparalleled.
Yeah, Billy and Bart Gunn know that they've got to get these two big mountain men off their feet. They've got to isolate either Jacob or Eli. Look at those elbow drives right to the sternum. The winner of the matchup at SummerSlam between Jacob and Eli Blue, Billy and Bart Gunn, no doubt will be in line for a WWF championship opportunity.
How do you win? You can't win for losing.
Hardy outthought himself there.
And of course, folks, SummerSlam totally sold out. The only seat left is on pay-per-view in your living room.
Uncle Zebekiah, as he says, he raised these two boys since they was pups. And he's a done a pretty good job in making them aggressive.
Well, move over, because we're watching the big dogs hunt right now.
Tag mate. Another quick tag by Jacob and Eli. There's a waist lock.
Uh-oh.
And a clothesline. And quite a job for Matt Hardy.
It's like falling off a building.
Leg hooked. It's academic at this point. Jacob and Eli Blue.
Here I go with her.
Collide with Billy and Bart Gunn in a very important tag team matchup. Coming up at SummerSlam, it's going to be live, and it's only on pay-per-view.
Well, folks, the waiting is over. The summer's hottest night is tonight. The Insider has packed his bags and is heading to the Igloo in Pittsburgh, because Supersize Stridex pads present SummerSlam tonight.
7 o'clock Eastern, 4 Pacific, exclusively on pay-per-view. You want to talk about an amazing card? We got it for you tonight at SummerSlam. World Wrestling Federation Championship on the line. Big Daddy Cool Diesel puts his title up for grabs the sixth time this year at a pay-per-view event when he meets the 568-pound King Mabel, who's already begun to unroll that royal plan.
Well, this is going to be a very physical affair. It will not be a beautifully scientific catch-as-catch-can matchup. Both these guys like to fight. They like to brawl. I think that's what we're going to see tonight. And I'm very concerned about the collusionary aspect of this situation. We know King Mabel and Sir Mo are joined at the hip, so to speak. But where does Davey Boy Smith fit into tonight's plan? And where does Jim Cornette, who is a master strategist, fit into this? I don't have that peaceful, easy feeling about Diesel's chances tonight in Pittsburgh.
Well, folks, you will also see the WWF Intercontinental Championship also up for grabs as the one and only Heartbreak Kid Shawn Michaels squares off against the man who oozes machismo, the bad guy Razor Ramon.
Two big fan favorites, two of the biggest egos in the entire World Wrestling Federation collide. They're also two of the most supreme athletes in the entire WWF as well. Razor Ramon has the opportunity to become the first four-time Intercontinental Champion in the entire history of the WWF. Well, ladies and gentlemen, now we're going to be joined by the reigning Intercontinental Champion, Shawn Michaels. And, Shawn, I hope this doesn't offend you, but why did you accept the terms of a ladder match knowing that you've already lost once to the bad guy?
Well, you know, I really appreciate you reminding me that. Lord knows I haven't heard enough of it over the last year and a half. You want to know why the ladder match? Why? Because I have not had a good night's sleep since the ladder match of 94. Shawn Michaels, the Heartbreak Kid, he tries to give everything to his fans. But I'm asking the fans just once, give me a little leeway, because, folks, I need this one for me. I need this one for the Heartbreak Kid. I'd like to get one good night of sleep knowing that Shawn Michaels, the Heartbreak Kid, climbed that ladder and staked his claim as the greatest athlete in World Wrestling Federation history and the greatest Intercontinental Champion ever.
The always confident Shawn Michaels. Jim Ross, it's going to be very interesting to hear the response of the fans of the World Wrestling Federation tonight. Shawn Michaels, Razor Ramon, obviously they both have their legions of fans. The question is, will the gold be going on the wall, the Heartbreak Hotel, or back to Miami with the bad guy, Razor Ramon? You will also see what Gorilla Monsoon has now dubbed the casket match between The Undertaker and Kama, the Million Dollar Corporation.
And we have seen a change in attitude, Todd, in recent days from The Undertaker. Ever since Kama put his hands on the Creatures of the Night and he hurt that young man, Undertaker has undergone a transformation. As a matter of fact, folks, we're going to show you just exactly how aggressive The Undertaker was last week on Raw when he went one-on-one with another member of the Million Dollar Corporation, the Native American, Tatanka. Welcome back, ladies and gentlemen. It's time for Hunter Hearst Helmsley to display his athletic prowess. Also like to remind everyone that many of our friends on America Online can enjoy SummerSlam tonight. Many of the great superstars in the World Wrestling Federation will be participating on America Online tonight.
We're back for action in 30 seconds.
Promotional consideration paid for by the following.
Welcome to Nerf Max Force. It starts with a flurry, 15 darts off in a hurry, muscled by the crank of Razor Beast. Max Force, it's Nerf to the next power.
Arcade graphics, arcade secrets, pulse-pounding music and sound effects. Nothing can prepare you for Mortal Kombat 2 on Sega Saturn. Let the combat continue from Acclaim.
For endless action, it's Batman Forever. With over 125 attacks and gadgets, Batman and Robin battle Two-Face and the Riddler in two-player cooperative fighting action. Batman Forever, coming September 7th from Acclaim.
Hunter Hearst Helmsley and Nick Barbera here on The Zone. And, of course, Hunter is undefeated in the WWF.
Him and that great Poupon attitude of his.
Oh, boy. He'll be taking on Will Hunter, Bob Sparkplug Holly this week. And Hunter is apparently a little disgusted with the odor, perhaps, from Nick Barbera.
What odor? I don't smell anything.
Didn't smell nothing.
I think I have your cold.
Good arm drag takeover. I'm feeling much better. That salve you got me last week really worked.
Cleaned you right out, didn't it?
Man, it did.
Can't leave the house, though, with that smell. Maybe what he's smelling.
Maybe it is.
You do smell a little postiferous.
Well, I'm working on it. The postiferous part.
What?
I don't know.
The smell?
Nick Barbera is maybe in for a smelly situation here. Hunter Hearst Helmsley has his way.
Well, how is he supposed to wrestle if he won't touch the guy?
Oh, he'll touch him all right. He'll put him in that pedigree if he gets a chance and dim his running lights.
You know, Nick Barberi cuts his own hair.
I did not know that.
Yep, looks right in the mirror, snip, snip, snip.
Well, Barberi just slapped Hunter, and he nailed him again with the right hand. Nick Barberi catching Hunter herself as he reverses the Irish whip. And, oh, Barberi got him in the cradle and got a two count.
Going for the old Horowitz.
Hey, anything can happen here in the World Wrestling Federation.
Hunter Hearst Helmsley cuts off the ropes but holds on.
Good move there.
And no drop kick for Nick Barberi.
That's smart, you know. They ought to put that on the new Windows 95. That's a smart move. Did you get your Windows 95 yet?
No.
Oh, you got to get it.
What is that?
What? It's for your computer.
I don't have a computer.
Are you kidding? Everybody has a computer.
Well, I got to catch up. I know.
What are you still using, the Abacus?
Got to get more contemporary. No, I don't even have one of those. Ooh. A hard elbow that Hunter Hearst Helmsley delivered to Nick Barberi. You know, we're going to be on the preview show later today.
That's right.
Live.
It's the Sunday Night Slam, baby.
Yep. Ototster and I will be live from Pittsburgh 1/2 hour prior to SummerSlam on the preview channel.
That would make it 6:30 Eastern, 3:30 Pacific.
And out in Oklahoma, 5:30.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
I don't know if Nick Barberi knows what time it is right now.
He may think he's Paula Barberi.
No kidding.
And Hunter, front face lock. And where's he going to take him? Pretty much up and down. You know, Hunter is from Greenwich, Connecticut. He is not a regal man. Don't be confused here, folks. This guy is from Greenwich, Connecticut, USA, and a rather pompous individual. I've been spending a little time in Greenwich here lately.
He's got a lap pool in his bedroom.
Oh, I didn't know that.
Oh, yeah.
Wow. Lots of money. Folks frown at me for driving through Greenwich in my truck.
Yeah, and, why do you do that?
That's all. Where am I going to go, walk? Oh, my. There's a pedigree.
Why don't you get a muffler?
Can't afford it. There's that lateral press, and Hunter can't afford to take his eyes off Bob Sparkplug Holly. Boy, Bob Holly would love to be the first man in a WWF to pin Hunter.
You see, those guys, those are the true fans of the World Wrestling Federation. Guys like me and you, you know, the fans. Not this guy with all the money and the superior attitude.
It's going to be fun, folks. SummerSlam sold out in the igloo. It's going to be live. And here's a live wire.
Yeah, ladies and gentlemen. Hey, Barry Dudinsky, what do you have for us, Barry?
Hey, guys, thanks a lot. Check it out. It's Bret Hart, and he's all over the place. He's all over the shirt, just like he's all over the WWF. Now, this shirt comes in one size fits all, and it's available by dialing 1-800-TITE-91 for only $20. Now, I'm going to flip around and show you the back to show you what all over means.
Flip around,
Barry. It means all over the front, and it means all over the back.
Thank you, Ian. Oh, boy.
I'm talking about Bret Hitman Hart.
What's he talking about?
I don't think Hunter likes that shirt.
This is decent clothes. Well, anyway, guys.
Pompous snob.
Oh, come on. Get out of there.
Sorry, Barry.
Got me. Yeah. The all-over print is available by dialing 1-800-TITE-91 for only $20. And if you dial 1-800-TITE-91, you get a free, that's right, free three-month subscription to WWF Magazine. Now, if you already are a subscriber, we'll tack on 3 months for you to your subscription.
Wait,
and by the way, folks, don't forget about Stridex. It's simple pimple control.
Yes.
Maximum strength. You get a box of this absolutely free as well. Back to you guys.
Boy, it worked on Barry, that Stridex.
Oh.
And if it can fix him up, it can fix anybody.
Boy, howdy. You're not kidding. Ladies and gentlemen, this is a bizarre individual. He is much maligned. He's gold dust. Weird.
In these hills of Hollywood, it's called stardom. I dreamt it. I bathe in it. I revel in it. That's why they call me Gold Dust. In time, your heartbreak kid will witness the presence a real star, not a figment of mere boy's imagination. There will soon be a permanent vacancy in the Heartbreak Hotel. So I say to you, come with me if you want to live. Hasta la vista, baby.
Well, apparently that individual, a big fan of the big screen.
Are you kidding? This guy looks like an Academy Award come to life. You know, an Oscar right off the pedestal.
I wonder what the folks in West Texas think about Gold Dust.
They don't think about Gold Dust.
But not much. Well, folks, what do you think about the bad guy? He's up next. Don't go away. This week, the Action Zone is brought to you by new
bigger. Stridex medicated pads. It's simple pimple control.
Now, folks, the bad guy Razor Ramon ready to lock up here this afternoon with Tony DeVito. And here comes the bad guy, oozing machismo. You know, don't get me on you because you got to send all your clothes to the dry cleaner.
I have been accused of oozing barbecue sauce on occasion.
You do if you squeeze you.
Yeah, a little gravy, a little biscuits.
Uh-huh.
A little Oklahoma flavor.
There you go. Look at that. And the bad guy is definitely focused and ready for Shawn Michaels tonight. You know, we mentioned it earlier on. It's going to be very interesting when these two individuals lock up in that ladder.
Shawn was a little irate, wasn't he?
Absolutely.
You know, we asked him a very simple question. You know, all the fireworks will be popping tonight. You know, he's 0-1 in ladder matches with Razor.
Well, don't bring it up to him, though. You saw what happened.
Trying to make a point. Razor Ramon is 6'7", 289. And the bad guy, Todd, doesn't have to climb as many rungs of the ladder to reach the belt that's going to be hanging over the ring. That's something that we haven't talked about. Shawn Michaels is about 6 feet tall. Razor, 7 inches taller. Got to give him a big advantage. He's stronger than Shawn Michaels. You know, physically, you got to think in this kind of match, the bad guy's got the advantage.
And certainly Razor Ramon has been acting differently since this matchup was signed by interim president Gorilla Monsoon and put into the SummerSlam card. He's not the same Razor Ramon.
Yeah, he's reverting somewhat back to his original ways when he first came to the WWF. He wasn't the most popular superstar, to say the least, at that time.
Well, I think it's that street savvy, too. He knows it's going to be a brawl with Shawn Michaels, and he's going to do whatever he has to do to become the first ever four-time Intercontinental Champion of the World Wrestling Federation.
Nice hip block out of the corner by Razor Ramon on the portly, compact Tony DeVito. You know, you do a great Burgess Meredith.
Oh, come on, that's Danny DeVito, because this is Tony DeVito.
Oh, come on. And that was a fallaway slam. Only kidding. I remember Batman forever and the other one, whatever it was.
The Batman.
Batman.
The first one.
Michael Keaton.
Right.
Has nothing to do with Razor Ramon.
Sorry.
Hey, I'll tell you something that's hot right now. It's not Michael Keaton, even though he's pretty warm. It's the WWF Superstar Line, folks. The number is 1-900-737-4WWF. It's only $1.49 per minute. Now, you know it's open 24 hours a day, 7 days a week. You know that the billing doesn't begin until you choose your option. And you know, kids, that you got to be 18 years of age or have your parents' permission before calling. On option six today, we're going to update you on some late-breaking news regarding Lex Luger and the British Bulldog.
Really?
A little update there. And also, I had a talk with Jim Cornette last night. And I'll share that with you on option six of the WWF Superstar Line.
Meantime, Razor Ramon slapping Tony DeVito around here this afternoon. And Tony is not responding well to the pressure.
You get the feeling that Razor is a little preoccupied. I mean, he's not, we're not seeing any great offensive moves. A move here, a move there. He seems like he's mentally preoccupied, and I guess that's, he's got a good excuse.
Well, also, I think a superstar of the caliber of the bad guy, Razor Ramon, loves a challenge in the squared circle. Tony DeVito's not giving it to him, but he's going to get all he can handle tonight in the ladder match with Shawn Michaels.
You know, as you pointed out, it's going to be very interesting to see the reception that these athletes, speaking of Razor and Shawn, get, because they're both big fan favorites. There's an abdominal stretch. The late Wilbur Snyder created that maneuver in back in the 1950s.
And Wilbur was a nice man, too.
Great guy.
Yep. Cut his own lawn, you know.
I didn't know that.
Yeah. Never let anybody else do it. He cut it like a baseball diamond.
He had a nice flat top. I remember that.
Sure.
Tony DeVito may need a flat top if he lands on his head here, because I got a feeling that this is not going to be a very nice trip. This is not going to be as fun as riding U.S. Air to Pittsburgh.
Oh, man.
Boy, that was a superplex and a half.
I would have to believe.
That's it.
There you see it from the bad guy, Razor Ramon.
Razor's Edge coming up. Shawn Michaels, best beware of this maneuver. I can promise you, the bad guy is going to try to execute this maneuver at SummerSlam on Shawn Michaels.
But it's not going to be that easy, I'll tell you that. Tony DeVito is all done here. All that's left is the three count. We'll get it here, and a victory for the bad guy, Razor Ramon.
As Monsoon used to say, stick a fork in him. He's done.
It's all over but the crying.
to Howard Romo's arms. Legendary.
Razor.
Ramon, legendary Howard figure. Folks, none of us will ever forget what we will see when we come back. And we are back, ladies and gentlemen. The White Angel, Hakushi, set to go one-on-one with perhaps the man of the hour right now, Todd. That man. Barry Horowitz.
I like when he pats himself on the back. I like Barry Horowitz.
You know, I was talking to Barry Dudinsky this the other day, and he's telling me that they're coming out with a new line of Barry Horowitz t-shirts.
You're kidding me.
Yep, no kidding. Absolutely serious.
Really?
Yep. Hakushi without a manager. Shinja is gone from the WWF thanks to Bret the Hitman Hart. And the White Angel certainly looking to redeem himself in the eyes of his countrymen. And you got to wonder, Todd, this guy's got one of the greatest one-loss records in the entire WWF. Hakushi has nothing to be ashamed of.
And you know what? That hat would make a great salad bowl for the Pettingill picnic.
Man, it holds some lettuce now.
You put a lot of salad in
that
thing.
Radishes.
Sure, fill it up. Look at all the writing all over him, too. I haven't been able to deduce what all that spells, but I know it's no good.
You think so?
It's no good with
maybe
this
you're a little
guy.
Cynical.
No. You watch Hakushi.
Well, Barry Horowitz is focused on Hakushi, and rightfully so. Earl Hebner, the referee for this contest, ladies and gentlemen. Capacity of crowd on hand with us, and we are so happy that you're with us wherever you may be.
We've heard a number of rumors that Barry Horowitz may in fact be appearing on the Tonight Show with Jay Leno
if he beats Skip tonight at SummerSlam.
Can you imagine? Oh, thank you very much, ladies and gentlemen. It's Barry Horowitz out here from the World Wrestling Federation, ladies and gentlemen.
But your chin's not there.
No.
But, you know, most people. Nice single leg picked up there by Barry Horowitz.
There's a very good one, Barry Horowitz from the World Wrestling Federation.
Horowitz has got a great amateur background,
mm-hmm.
and certainly sound fundamentally. Is the crowd chanting, Barry, Barry. Look at a big hand in the Civic Arena.
He's not used to that.
No. He's overwhelmed by this, and it couldn't happen to a nicer guy.
He's got his hands full with Hakushi.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, look at this.
Nice leg drag by Hakushi. Hakushi and the 1-2-3 kid tonight. Better turn around there, Barry. Can't take it.
Wait a minute. Here comes Skip.
And Sonny.
Brother.
I cannot. Somebody needs to muzzle those two egomaniacs.
Put them in a cage and leave them back there.
Well, I'll tell you something. Horowitz got that upset victory over Skip right here on the zone. We had the privilege of calling it. And if he beats Hakushi, that's got to be even bigger, at least in my opinion, Todd, in beating Skip.
Hey, well, why are Skip and Sonny at ringside? I don't understand. That match doesn't happen until tonight.
Oh, they'd love to have Barry Horowitz lose this match and be humiliated, maybe even be injured. You know, Skip wants to cover all his bases. He can't afford another humiliating loss to Barry Horowitz, especially at SummerSlam. It's Skip's first pay-per-view in the WWF as well.
Well, I'll tell you what, Horowitz is going for the three-peat.
And Barry's looking up because he saw it coming. Did Barry Horowitz and able to move out of the way? Well, I'll tell you, if you like topes and planches and all those high-flying moves, taking all those chances, you'll see that tonight when the 1-2-3 kid takes on Hakushi at SummerSlam.
Look at this. They cannot believe what they're seeing. Barry Horowitz turning his head against Hakushi.
One, two, and a near fall.
Oh, he almost had it.
Skip and Sonny almost coming out of their workout attire there. That would be embarrassing.
Yeah.
Nice athletic maneuver there by Hakushi, and Horowitz goes outside. Barry Horowitz on the outside. There goes Skip, and look at Sonny. She wants to distract the referee. That's not right. Horowitz, hey, ref, take a look
out
here.
Somebody do something. Get away from her.
He could get run over by a truck, and the referee wouldn't see it. Boy, I tell you, that's so frustrating. It's not fair.
Horowitz really holding his own against Hakushi, then Skip and Sonny coming down. Who knows what's going to happen here?
I was just tightening the ropes over there.
Oh, yeah, right. Sure you were. You're like Davy Boy Smith. You're a liar.
I'm not doing nothing.
I'm not doing nothing. Why don't you go back to the locker room then? Banish him from ringside. Throw him out, ref.
Hakushi.
Look at that cheap shot there, Todd.
Look at Hakushi just waiting for an opportunity. Whoa.
And then got it himself from Hakushi. Man, Hakushi is so gifted. Nice drop kick by Hakushi.
He is just so quick. You make one small mistake.
Cover.
There it is.
Got it. No.
Did he get him?
Half a tenth. I think he liked about 2.5 there. Hakushi is reversed by Barry Horowitz. Horowitz misses the elbow. And there's a waist lock by Hakushi. Horowitz with the elbow again.
Yes!
Countering. There's a waist lock by Horowitz now. He's going to try to roll Hakushi out. That's not going to work. Skips up for the apron. Hey, get down! Get him down! And, oh, Hakushi and Skip run together.
Wait a minute.
Get him.
Two! He got it!
Horowitz wins again!
He got it!
Wins again! Horowitz wins again! Can you believe it?
Barry Horowitz with his second victory in the World Wrestling Federation. Make that third. He beat Skip twice.
Barry Horowitz goes to SummerSlam with momentum. He can't believe it. And it's not going to be a pretty sight here when the man from the rising sun awakes from his nap.
How about that? See? We said it before. You never know what's going to happen to the World Wrestling Federation. These guys came out hoping for... What?
Well, because you and your buddy came down and interfered. And Hakushi is up now, and he is not happy.
Uh-oh.
Let him have it, Hakushi. Hakushi shoves Skip down. I don't know what she's doing. Now, she's got no business in the ring. And here comes Skip, and there's a high elevation.
Oh, look at that.
Skip with a body down. Being battered here before SummerSlam. Makes that U-turn. Gets tangled up in the ropes, and outside he goes. Skip and Sonny cannot believe it. Their planned interference backfired. I'm sure Hakushi knew nothing of Skip and Sonny's plan. Hakushi does not speak English.
Of course not. I mean, it just happens. Things happen. These guys came down hoping for Barry Horowitz to lose. They were running their tracks at Barry, and it backfired. And I love it.
Boy, there's going to be an exciting SummerSlam. You just never know. Tonight at SummerSlam, and when we come back, Doc Hendricks interviews the Hitman.
Stay with us, folks.
The offices of Isaac Yankum BDS are closed. He has an appointment this Sunday night at SummerSlam with the Hitman Bret Hart to extract revenge for the King Jerry Lawler. Isaac Yankum DDS will be available for root canals, gum surgery, and tooth extraction next week. But if you have an urgent message for Isaac Yankum, please leave it after the drill.
We want Bret. That's what they're chanting. Doc Hendricks called up and Bret Hart earlier this week on the World Wrestling Federation Tour de Force.
Are you ready for the best there is, the best there was, and the best there'll ever be?
Not sure there's one button.
I know.
Why? Think he's putting on weight. Thinks
when you get up on your feet, get butt out of your seat.
Here comes the best there is, the best there was, the best there ever will be. Doc, maybe flying free as a bird before this one's all said and done. He doesn't walk the straight and narrow with Bret Hart. Bret stepping in the ring with the unknown. The almost 7 feet, over 300 pounds.
Oh, look at Doc.
Doc.
Oh, the Hitman gives Doc Hendricks a little look there, huh?
He catches him, he's going to give him more than that. Maybe give him the sharpshooter. The fact that Jerry Lawler is going to be sitting at ringside during that matchup, doing the broadcast with Vince McMahon at SummerSlam.
Well, you never know what Lawler's going to do.
They'll
all
lock
right,
him
out. Bret, here we are, this Sunday, SummerSlam. You are facing an opponent that you have not had any time to prepare for because you've never seen him in the ring. Now, if we were to believe the King Jerry Lawler, he says that he is a holy terror. And that he's going to extract some revenge, and we know that Jerry Lawler will do anything to get back at you. What we all want to know is exactly what is the excellence of execution going to do?
Good question, Doc. Big softball.
Isn't it just like Jerry Lawler? Here's a guy, you know, he just didn't like the fact that I had my five little piggies and his own five little piggies rammed down his dirty, rotten, stinking throat.
That's right.
So what has he done? He's gone out, and he's got somebody else to do his job for him. Well, that's just like Jerry Lawler. Now, I don't know anything about Isaac Yankum DDS. I don't know if he's supposed to be a dentist. Yeah, like maybe I'm a brain surgeon. You know, I don't really care if he's a dentist. Dentists don't intimidate me. It's different maybe if he was a heart surgeon. But the fact is, Isaac Yankum, maybe you should take careful note. Because you talk about being a tough guy. Well, I've seen a lot of tough guys. They come and go. But the toughest guy in the World Wrestling Federation that's proved it year in and year out is right here. The excellence of execution.
She's got something in her nose.
The best there is.
It was in the ring.
The best there was and the best there ever will be. I'm going to be 100%. And in the SummerSlam, I am going to shine. I am going to wipe you out just because I don't like anybody that hangs around with scum and slime like Jerry Lawler. So you can bring every single thing you got, Mr. Dentist. But the one thing that you are going to need in the SummerSlam is lots and lots of Novocaine.
There you go. Well, it's going to be something. What's going to happen when the Hitman takes on the huge Isaac Yankum? For that matter, what's going to happen when King Mabel's plan unfolds as it relates to Big Daddy Cool and the WWF title? Let's take a special look at SummerSlam.